Good morning to everyone. My name is Ramesh, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce, Soundarya Institute of Management and Science, Bangalore. Now I am going to explain weighted mean. It is in the topic under the unit number 3, Measures of Central Tendency, in the subject Quantitative Analysis for Business Decision or Business Statistics of Bangalore University, second semester BCom and second semester BBA courses. Now I am going to explain about weighted mean. You are in life, daily life, we will give some importance for the certain things. So far we studied common mean only we studied, but each one group have equal importance for all the numbers. Here, not like that. Here, whichever is important, then we will give. For example, in household items, we will purchase each one have different quantity. Rice 25 kgs, 50 kgs, 75 kgs, 100 kgs. It depends on the family. Oil 5 liter, 10 liter, 15 liter, and then mustard, cramp. So each one have different measurement, different quantity. All quantity will never be same. Something will buy grams, something will buy kgs, something will buy quintals. It depends on the items will be purchased. So depends on the items will give up importance. So that is the only weightage. Here is given subject, marks, weight. Subject is Kannada, English, Science, Mathematics, Social Science. Values are 60, 75, 63, 59, 53. Weightage will be given. Kannada will be 1, English will be 2, Science will be 1, Mathematics will be 3, Social Science will be 3. So this is one of the example I have taken. So this example will be written as X will be the given marks. The weightage will be W. According to that, we are written total weightage 1 plus 2 plus 1 plus 3 plus 3 is 10. Then you have to find out W into X. 1 into 60, 60. 2 into 75, 150. 1 into 63, 63. 3 into 59, 177. 3 into 53, 159. Summation WX equal to 609. So this is the way we can total, because the formula is weighted mean equal to X bar W equal to summation WX divided by summation W. So substitute the values 609 divided by 10. So 60.9 is the weightage. So in this way, weighted mean will be calculated. Here, items will be given. What is the weightage will be given for that? Next one, here as some numbers is given, 40, 45, 80, 75 and 50. Have the weights are 3, 2, 3, 2 and 1 respectively. What is the weighted mean? So we can go through that. We'll be writing as X, 40, 45, 80, 75, 50. Weightage 3, 2, 3, 2, 1. So total weightage is 11. So summation W equal to 11. So W into X multiply 3 into 40, 120. 2 into 45, 90. 3 into 80, 240. 2 into 75, 150. 1 into 50, 50. So total of this, you'll get 650. So summation WX equal to 650. So formula we know, summation WX divided by summation W, 650 divided by 11, because 11 is the value, 59.09. This is the way weighted mean we can solve it. Another one example will be taken. The given values numbers will be written as 90, 35, 20, 55, 70, 75 as X. Weightage will be 6, 5, 4, 2, 2, 1. 6 plus 5 plus 4 plus 2 plus 2 plus 1. It is 20. Summation WX equal to 6 into 90, 540. 3 into 35, 175. 4 into 20, 80. 2 into 55, 110. 2 into 70, 140. 1 into 75, 75. So all the values total 1120. Therefore, weighted mean equal to summation WX divided by summation W, 1120 divided by 20, simplify 56. This is the way we can able to follow the weighted mean. Another one question. Here, rain falls for a month. as recorded in an observation is as follows. Days and rainfall in millimeter. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. 87, 63, 74, 56, 62, 85, 73. There are 5 Mondays, Tuesdays, Wednesdays, 4 Sundays, Thursdays, Fridays and Saturdays. Now we can write in the X and W. 87, 63, 74, 56, 62, 85, 73. W is 4, 5, 5, 5, 5, 4, 4, 4. Total of W is 31. Here W into X. 4 into 87, 348. 5 into 63, 315. 5 into 74, 370. 5 into 56, 280. 4 into 62, 248. 4 into 85, 340. 4 into 73, 292. Sum of WX column equal to 2193. So this is the way we can follow that. Then summation WX divided by summation W, 2193 divided by 31. Simplify the value 70.741 weighted mean. This is another way the problem is given to understand what is X, what is W, then you can calculate. Thank you for watching my video. We will continue in the next video. Thank you for your best watchers.